Oh, wow, you got here before I did. Oh, golly, am I not surprised? Oh, it's a great day in the Clemmer household. Oh, my goodness. Oh, and you know, it's one of those days when I've got to put my lipstick on. And hold on, I've got to yell at my husband real quick. Well, call to him lovingly. How about that? I did an Emily Letella on him. You know what that is? Do you? Oh my goodness, I don't even have all my lights on. Never mind. What a day to have my voice go out on me, but it's coming back, but it's, you know, oh boy, it's one of those days. Oh my goodness, Marcy, she's got a granddaughter graduating from the fourth grade. I didn't even put all my lipstick on. How about that? I love this. Ready when you are. You know, I have had such a great week. I mean, I've been sick. If I don't really watch my sinuses and stuff, I can get it gets too thick and it sticks to my vocal cords. Hold on. And unfortunately, if I cough a lot, next thing you know, yeah, I'm gonna be blowing my nose, and that's not gonna be pretty either. So, I've got 10 people coming for dinner tonight, and golly, what to do? What to do? I'm not Martha Stewart, okay? I have better stamps and accessories than she does. Just my personal opinion there. So what are you up to today? And I want to know, I gotta tell you, okay, you're my friends. I can be candid. But I have one of those few jobs where you can text your friend and say, I'm butt naked and I'm gonna be on in 18 minutes. Yes, I did that. So, how many of you have been to our live stamp sales that we have on the first Friday of every month? This will be the third one. And so, third time's a charm. And I'm going to be asking you what you want to see. Oh, Connie, how you doing? And let's see, Connie, we got Sharon in New Zealand. Oh, Sharon, yeah, I got to talk to make a presentation for many of my demonstrator friends, many of which who were on or live in Australia. Hold on, I moved everything here, and I've got to move the dog cam here. He's over here licking my leg. Oh, baby.
Well, yes.
And anyway, I have to tell you, the nicest thing happened was. Someone wrote me, made a comment that they felt like they were, you know, I was in their front room talking to them. And I'm like going, oh, that is just the nicest thing you could say. So I'm going to encourage you to go and tell somebody something nice today. I don't care if it's the lady who's standing in front of you in line and you want to tell her you like her haircut. You know, maybe you might want to, email your upline and tell her, you know, that you like all her support. Email one of your downlines, tell them, wow, you've been doing a great job. You know, just tell anybody. You know, tell Nita. Oh my goodness, you're so smart. I can't laugh, can't laugh. Hold on. So there's a couple. Wait a minute, I'm gonna have to call him. Hold it again. What would I do without him? Now, many people can do it on their own, but not everybody. You know, I mean, it's so much easier for me when he can corral the dog, or if I forget something, which is often done. You know, I mean, he can help me with that, and so, you know, I really appreciate that. Oh, and of course, we have another smart person here. Yep, my friend Amy. So. Yeah, it's been such a great day. So thank you. I want to encourage you to go and tell somebody something nice. Go ahead and make their day. Now, I'm not telling you to go and, you know, say anything that isn't true, because I'm going to show you something that I went and shared on a professional call recently. Here you go. Yeah, just one of my, my, you know, mantras in life. Hold on. Oh, Sandy, it is so good to see you here. My goal is to make you smile today. So, as far as making a quick and easy card, you know, I should not be trusted to tell you in advance what I'm going to do, because I have blinked since then, okay? I only put it up last night. And Cecil, this dog is licking my leg. Hold on, maybe he just wants to come up. Do you want to get him up and get hair all over my... No, he heard me call my husband, so there he goes. You know, he gets hair all over me, and I love him for it, but, you know, it's great, better at the end. So, anyway, now he's back again. Stamper, do you want to come up? As soon as I say that, he just backs up. So, there's a couple things. You know, we only have 2 days left of... You know, this month, that means 2 days left of the catalog, 2 days left of the special, the bundle special, and, you know, the picture that I left in the other room where you can get the big bundles and free items with them. Now, you can buy those things in the catalog when they come out June 1st. However, getting them now, you get extra free stuff, and that is way cool. We also have our sweet treats. Now, this is a little bit closer and I can get it. Not that. Yes. This just gives you an idea of what we go through with sweet treats. Barbara will be here on Friday, and we'll be ordering our stuff for free sweet treats and stuff. And so here. Oh, pick one in. There. I'll pick that one. You can get a little bit of everything in the catalog. Now, I'm going to show you these. You know, I like to show these really close if I can. And there you go. Look at these. These are in the bundles right now. And they're also going to be part of the sweet treats. And what we do, we go and take these and then we just cut. So you're going to get two of each of these colors, right? Then you'll also get a 6x6 piece of all the designer series paper, and yeah, there's going to be it's lots of stuff. And if you go and look on, I believe it's the May 27th bark that the dog did, he's not laying down yet, then you can see everything that you get, because I'm going to cut it off. I think I only have room for about three more at this point. I try to only do it for a short period of time so that, you know, you want me to be making cards. You don't want me to be going, okay, let's go and cut this in little strips and package it up and do all those fun things that I love to do for you. So, here's Laura. Laura's one of my demonstrators that lives in Tennessee. She used to live in Idaho. Now she lives in Tennessee. And yeah, hey, 3x3 card gift sets. That's a pretty cool thing. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to talk to you about things that you should get. And if any of you have an idea of what things you might want to think about getting before the new catalog comes out, you know, and I'm not going to tell you why, but all I'm going to say is that you should trust me, because you know I would not steer you wrong. And one of those things is the shimmery cardstock. And of course, what did I do? I went in and zoomed out, you know, so yeah, because it's kind of hard to see, but I did it on this. Now, you might think that the shimmery cardstock is a little bit pricey. And it is, but I think that it's cheaper. I've never done a cost comparison, but it's cheaper than watercolor paper. Now, it doesn't take as much water as watercolor paper, but it does go in, you can watercolor on it like I did on this one. And this week, if you want to go over to the dog's blog, you will see something that I watercolored. That's in the front room, too. And I showed what the back of it looked like, and it really looked nice enough to go. And, I could have used that, but it would have been a little bit, a little bit different. So this is going away. Let's see. I don't have enough light in here to make that sparkle show up. So I know that this ribbon is going away. They do keep some of the ribbon, but okay, if I do this just right there, you can see the shimmer, because it just shimmers enough to where when you're hold, there we go. I hope you can see that there, right? Yeah. So anyway, that's one of the things that you want to stock up on. The other thing, you might really want to look at any paper products. If you want the old style stamp ink pads, you might want to get that. And of course, you want to look at what stamp sets that have been on your wish list for a while, like this one, because I'm gonna color that today. And if you like watching paint dry, you can watch me color it for a little bit with the Stampin' Blends. And the Stampin' Blends came back. I mean, is that cool? Now, these are just the colors that we were carrying before. They're back. But the new colors that are in the new catalog, if you already have one, those will be available in mid-June. Now, it'd be great if you could go and, and have everything happen at the right time. Okay, the new catalog starts June 1st. But that's like expecting all the guests tonight to show up right on time. So, Hey, well, I'm glad you like that, Stacy. Hey, if any of you are new, make sure that you mention it in the comments, because some of you have been coming for a while, but you don't say a lot, so I don't really know you're here. And then, or maybe this is your very first time. And so anyway, so this is one of the stamp sets I think is really great. Now, if I had one way you could do this, you could mask this, cut this out, go color it and then mask it and then stamp this so that it's in the background. We could, if you stamp this first, like a crumb cake or something really light in the background, it would muddy your colors, I think. I don't want to try it. How about that? You can try it. Let me know. Another thing is this, and this is what I sent my husband out for. This is a great stamp set to have. This, right? And because everybody has birthdays. I mean, you could go and do, happy 8th birthday, happy 24th birthday, happy, where do you find a 23rd birthday card? You don't. And so it's really good to have with, and I don't have the whole thing here, but here are the framelits, and they come with something that matches this, which is bigger than that. It's, by the way, this will not be on the sale on Friday. I'm just telling you that now. So hey, let's welcome Sharon. Yay! Go, Sharon. So you can stamp these in a curve over the numbers. You can put some of the words in here, and then there's a die that goes with that. But this is great, and I'll be showing you the alternative version of this, because it turns out you gotta love this. My husband, who graduated before I did and went to school on the other side of the United States, has the same school colors I do. So how about that? Now, hey, if you really need to chat, It's so much better. I wish I could give you a microphone today. But please share this with your friends because, you know, they might want to see how the stamp and blends are done. You know, of course, we're going to stamp a little bit, but it really makes my day if you like me over on Facebook. You know, don't like me, like the dog. I mean, yes, the director is in. Yay! Yes. Stamper, do you need someone to say something nice to you? Yes. You need someone to say something nice to you? Like, you are such a good dog. Yes, you are. Hold on. Okay, I hope you didn't hear that. Boy, that was awful. But anyway, and subscribe. If you're over on YouTube, please subscribe. We love it. Oh my goodness, see, look how smart. I told you that Nita was smart. See, she made a 39th anniversary card. And you know what? 39 isn't 40, but isn't that a long time? Now, I am really blessed. You know, a lot of my friends have been married a long time. Might have something to do with going to church. Could be. Anyway, but not everybody has the same life experience, you know? And so, anyway, it's easy for me to say he's my favorite husband, okay? Note to self, don't laugh. But anyway, 39 years, that's a big accomplishment. So how nice will your friend feel if you go and give them a card that says happy 39th anniversary? Well, here is a card that I made, and you might have seen it on the dog's blog, but we also made a different version of it using the same concept, but a different version of it. For Cecil's niece, right? And it's black and gold, and the words are different. And this is for someone who goes to, it goes to Faith Christian up here. And so she's graduating on Friday, and she's going to get that. And I think her grandma will see it in advance, but that's okay. That's okay. So I want to ask you, if you're interested in coming on Friday, because Friday's a really hot day, would you rather see some stamp sets that have not been in the catalog for a while, or would you like to see stamp sets that are like new? Because I'm pretty sure I'm selling this one on Friday, right? But I came across some stamp sets that have not been in the catalog for a few years. So would you like to see old, newly retired, or a combination of both? So if you could just write in the comments below, whether you're on YouTube or Facebook, then that will help me, because I have a box of one picked out and I have a huge box of the others that I could pick from, but we're going to do the selection on Friday morning. So here's your chance to be a contributor to the show on Friday and let us know what would you like to see. Now, we already have someone over on YouTube that says new. Now, that doesn't make that the right answer for you, the right way to vote for you. Just go and just tell me how you feel. You know, I mean, so anyway, there you go. Now, here we go. Where'd I put the piece of paper? You know how that is. Yes, here it is, my sparkly piece of paper. Okay, so it's gonna be what it's gonna be. How about that? Now, if you think that this is kind of expensive, you know, because it is, you know, it's like 10 sheets for I think $8.50 right now, but it's very versatile. And if you think about it, that 10 sheets will give you 40 cards, because like when I did this one, this is the thick Whisper White, and this is the Shimmery White. Now, there's a slight difference in it because, you know, it's the Shimmery White isn't exactly right. However, you know, it's negligible. It doesn't really bother me because this really pops so much. But when you think, you know, 40 card fronts with a Shimmery White, you know, for $8.50, that's not bad. So I'm, in fact, here, I'm going to be lazy. I'm going to even do, and it's not necessarily the same card, but it's going to be the same colors. Oh, note to self. Okay, let's see if I can just wiggle my nose and the stamp pad will appear. And the empty homemade yogurt container will disappear. Golly, I know magic. So, yeah, hey, LA, she's got the right idea. It's going to be fine. You know, I just wanted to, because I had one plan and then I went, well, you know what? The way today worked out, you don't know how blessed I am. Yeah, because of this, right? I was going to, by the way, when you do this, I like to use Tuxedo Black, Memento Ink. I'm going to show you something else. Should be on your list. Throw that in. Someone's got a wash it pile. Let me show you one more thing. Did you get a Stamparatus? Did you? Make that comment below because I got something to show you. I bought this stamp set just for... Sorry, when I get in and out of here. Uh-oh, I lost my pillow, so now I'm going to be lower. Maybe I better sit up straight. How about that? I bought this just for the Stamparatus, right? And the reason why is because you can lay this... You get a thinner piece of cardstock and lay this and have, like, either the flags or you can have the lights going like this down your card... You know, which, hey, great, you know. You can also go and put a tree on this side and a tree on that side. And then here's a hammock. So I'm going to have to do a couple of these for the people who got the Stamparatus from me. I'll do some lives because this is going away. And it's perfect for the Stamparatus. It's a... photopolymer set, so you can see where to place it. Those are work really well, especially when you put our really thin Teflon mat in there. And so, get this. You know, just get this if you've got a Stamparatus before it goes away, because it makes such impressive things. Where you can make lots of them with, you know, it's summertime. You're gonna be making cards for people who have summer birthdays. Here's congratulations, happy birthday. So yeah. And like, even when I talked about these, you know, to get these numbers before they go away, you do want to get them, even though, okay, graduation season, it will be over by the time you get them, you know, or unless you, you know, come on, who has never sent a belated card? Come on. You're going to have other people having birthdays and everything. So anyway, there. And hey, okay, shameless plug. There you go. Now, if you're holding off ordering because you are going to order big out of the first catalog or the catalog when it first comes out, let me know and I can help put the two orders together so that it'll add to your hostess benefits. So, yeah, I highly recommend it. If you're going to be doing any, you know, because of the Stamparatus, mainly because of the Stamparatus. So let's go in. Boy, too bad I couldn't play music on this, you know. There's copyright issues, so you really can't. Oh, and the other thing, if the Stamparatus is not in your future, and you know what, that's okay. The Stamp-a-Majig, right? If you go to my store and search on the word jig so that you get it right, that is $9.40 on the clearance rack right now, okay? $9.40. Cheap. So in the real world, you know, when you start doing these, watercoloring, you really should go and put a little gray, you know, around the edges and shadow first. It's I wouldn't necessarily do it with the Stampin' Blends, but a watercolor pencil is great, where you would, I'm just looking to see where they are, just go along the edge and then fade out a little bit of shadow, because do that first, because if you, you can cover it up if you miss it a little bit, but it's not going to be, it's not going to be pretty if you go in. See here, I'll show you right here. It, there you go. If you look really close, see, look at, I bled a little bit, but that was not because I shaded later. So let's go real close. Do any of you not have the Stampin' Blend? Because they really make it to where everybody can color. Now there's a couple different ways you can do it. I do it different ways, different times. You can go and I tend to do one petal at a time. You can color it with, okay, Anne. I have lotion on, so it's like getting the cap off is fun. I can go over it with light first and then shade it around here where I want it to be dark. Well, golly, that's really not good, right? However, if I go over here and then I'll start giving a little circular motion here. Oh, golly, that looks so intense there. Doesn't do it like that when I'm by myself, ever. Now, here, see what I mean? Goes through, but it doesn't hit all the way down here. Not as if you were doing, well, this one I might do all dark. This one, now here we'll try it another way. We'll put the dark in first, and then we'll go over it with the light and see if that blends better. You know, it's just different things, different times. But remember that when you're zoomed in like that, it does tend to, see, look at this, doesn't look as intense as it did when I first did it. Yeah, you know, here, this is Cameo Coral. Now, golly, I'm dating myself. Calypso Coral. And I don't use it a lot, but when I use it, I like it. See, look at, maybe that wasn't all the way dry, but that's okay. It's just, you know, it's not really, I should have a light right coming from here so you could see this better. Note to self, do it right next time. And remember, you can get the, see that, boy, doesn't that look like more special? Oh yeah, hey, Sharon's going to work now. Is this dark? So really, you just kind of think about where would it be dark. It's going to be dark on the inside, underside of the leaf and on the inside. Woo! Well, I just drew on it. How about that? A lot of the time I use the thin side, but for some reason, the thick side's working fairly well for me today. Now, see how intense that is now? Let's see if it gets less intense in a second. There's something about letting it, quitting just before you think it's right. I'm just trying to get a little bit more in there where it, now I'm going to add more, so maybe I'm, and if you think that I'm a professional artist, oh wait, I am. Boy, I sound like a 60-year-old smoker, I tell you. Actually, I don't think of myself as an artist. I think of myself as your friend. I just do. In fact, I just made a new friend on Facebook today, and she, now she's probably a real art. She's part of the design team on for Stampin' Up, and that's what's kind of cool. They have all kind of things that that you can excel in with Stampin' Up. They've got, you know, like people who are really artistic can be on the, wow, look at, I went outside the line. Life is over as we know it. You know, you can work towards that if that's your gift. If you want, you know, if you just want to buy things at a discount, that works too. You know, I mean, if you want to work towards sales, great. Now, after this is dry, we have a magic thing we call, well, I call it the magic eraser. But let's see. Color Lifter is the real name for it. But the hint is, don't go and use the Color Lifter until it's dry, because that otherwise that's probably what happened here a little bit. I used it to erase where I went outside the line. And so, yeah. Well, hey, you know what? You try to color with, you know, with a million people looking at you. Yeah, right. Yeah. You know, this will take me forever. I'm not going to do the whole thing, but I'm just trying to give you an idea that you really don't have to be, you just have to kind of, it helps to know where the shadow would be. And guess what? Most people do. They just don't really think about it. I will tell you, though, my mother did send me for oil painting lessons when I was in the, summer of the 7th grade, I think, 8th grade, something like that. After the 7th grade, yeah, because my grandfather had passed away, and my, I'm not making these good decisions here, and my, my brother had been staying out with my grandmother after my grand, because, you know, my grandparents had been married 60 years and my grandmother didn't drive. And so my brother went out and stayed there. And then during the summer, I went out and stayed with my grandma because my brother was old enough to drive and I wasn't. And my mother would come and get me and send me out to oil painting lessons. She was big on, you know, learning how to do things. Now, that doesn't mean anything other than, like, just like with everything else, the more you do it, the better you get. On the other hand, I do tend to have beginner's luck. So, hey, I'm glad, you know, Stacy likes this color, and I see that Karen likes the flower stamp. Yeah, it's really a great one to have because I don't color a lot. I'm more into Fast and Fabulous. Anyway, you could see, golly, it really looks better. It looks different in real life. I'm going to tell you that now. It looks different in real life. The colors are more, I keep wanting to say one more. The colors are, I don't know. They're just a little bit more intense or something. But you notice there is, I don't do it the same way all the time. Sometimes I put the light on first, and sometimes I do put the dark on first. And then sometimes I do both. So, hey, let me move on to some, as soon as I get rid of this line here. But you notice I do one at a time. Now, that's because these are alcohol inks and they tend to dry very quickly. And so you would want them to, you want to get in there and blend them real quick. And you don't have to use circular, you know. That's another thing. Sometimes just going and doing, I'll try this on the leaves maybe. Make sure I got the right ones on here. Yes, you want to do this until it clicks. Oh, I hope I was doing that on camera. I wasn't watching. So for those of you who do live things, I'm going to yes, vibrant is the word. Vibrant is the word. You could tell a little bit more of the difference in color. See, this would be great, except for I've got lotion on my hands, so it's like, oh great, okay. For those of you who do live videos, and I know that some of you are just starting into live video, I want to give you one little hint, and let's see if this helps you. If you do nothing else, please don't look at yourself when you're talking to the camera, okay? That's all I'm saying. Just because I'm looking at you. I'm imagining you're sitting there in front of your computer, in front of your phone, and you're going, wow, this is like watching paint dry. No, I'm imagining that you're saying, wow, you know, it's kind of soothing to watch coloring. You know, that's when I want to color. I usually like Fast and Fabulous, like I said, but there's sometimes when I just want to sit down and, you know, sit there with the dog down here. Oh, he's not down there. Sorry. Oh boy, sorry. You know, and just sit there and color, and it's just really nice and soothing, and you know, you just do it when you feel like it. Now, if you like to color all the time, then color to your heart's content. We have that designer series paper that's going away that you can just go and color, and I took it out front. You know, we have company coming, so you gotta have the cards out. Oh no, it's over here. Hold on. I just did this the other night, and it's not the perfect card, but I think it would get the point across. If you look really close, this is that designer series paper that you go and designer series paper that you go and you know, can color. And this stamp set is really good. It's another one that's going away. And you can color the whole thing. You can leave it black and white, whatever. But the good thing about the stamp set, it's got really big greetings. So you could just do that and that's it. But I just sat there and, first of all, I went and I stamped the black. Then I went over it with Smoky Slate. And I went over these parts that are the shadows, and then I colored Cherry Cobbler and Old Olive light ones, you know, just all over. Now, it's more of a Mary Engelbrecht look as far as the background. My favorite artist, by the way, other than the original Stampin' Up! Artist. But yeah, this is a big thank you. And what's most important, someone's going to keep this because it's what you write inside, you know, that will make them, you know, thankful that you made them a card. So let's get back to finishing this part up. I had notes and everything of things I was going to tell you, but that, no, that just went south. You know, I have to tell you, I get so excited to do this. I really do. I get so excited. Last night, I couldn't go to sleep. I mean, it was 4 o'clock in the morning, and I was not asleep yet. So, yeah, that's what I'm blaming it on. So here, go a little bit, maybe a little bit closer, not quite as close this time. Maybe you do need to see. What I wanted to show you is that you can go and, okay, here I'm just doing this in the light, Old Olive, right? Oh, you have never seen this stamp set, Paula? This is called You've Got This, and it goes away when they sell out, or it goes away when it sells out, or tomorrow, whatever comes first. So here I've done it in the light Old Olive. Well, now I'm going to go over it again. Oh, note to self. Well, you know what? I have to put lotion on my hands or else you're going to go and say, golly, look at those hangnails. Okay, so see, look at, you don't have to have, use both of them. Colored the wrong side here. But you can see, well there, I'm just gonna color it all the way in. And see here the line is, you know, the stem is the light, and the, I just went over it twice. But you do wanna buy the duos. Just buy the duos because it's two different things. Because okay, this one that's slightly lighter, not a lot lighter, but I'm gonna go over it with the okay. Come on, Ann. Oh, the trials and tribulations of being a Stampin' Up! Demonstrator. See, look at that's way darker. So that gives you an idea of how well these work. But hey, go and check out the dog's wrong end. Dog's blog today. We've got some stuff, and on Friday, if you know, I didn't even talk about this, but on Friday, if you want to have a reminder to come during just a few minutes before the show, if you have Facebook Messenger, when I send you a reminder a couple minutes before we start. And I'll put that out there again. If you're on YouTube, just go to stamperdog.com/stampthis. But if you are on Facebook, then you want to just type stamp this below. So you can do either way. But if you're on Facebook now, just type stamp this below. And hey, let me go get this other stamp set. This, I believe, was designed by our CEO's husband. Mr. Douglas. We'll call him Mr. Douglas today. Sean. But see, it's bigger than this. And this is bigger than this. See, they're see how huge they are? I take those bits off, so. Oh, I usually do. I didn't hear, but see, this gives you an idea how big it is. There you go. Yeah. Heck yes, we need to celebrate this. He's really big into fonts. I might be selling this one. I haven't decided. I've got it in there backwards, upside down, and front side back. But it, you know, they're great. A bit of green under the flower. You mean like this? No, I'm not going to do green under there. I'm going to do, that's a petal. And this I'm going to do yellow. I'll do something with this because you notice I didn't even cut. I usually cut my stuff. So, you know, I hope that you're able to go in and join us on Friday. Friday at 4:00 Pacific time. Look at First Friday Online Stamp Sale. And what's really cool about it is that everybody who orders gets a gift in their stuff. And it depends. All it is I add an extra ounce to your shipping. And then whatever I can get in there, that's what you get. So it kind of works out great. You do have to be in the United States and have a U.S. mailing address for me to send it to you. If you are on YouTube, you really need to be going over and following us on the dog's Facebook page. Or else, maybe not during the event, but later, or even better yet, let me write this down for you. Okay, so it's Stamper Dog. Do you know how many times it's Gmail would be so much faster, you know, to write. You know, when you're making out those things, say, hey, I want to win a vacation. You know, those things, yeah. So, okay. And then there's a slash here, right? And if you write this, this will take you to the dog's rubber garage sale. He's already got some stuff there that is, golly, yeah. Hello, there you go. That's for sale now. But what it is that when it's done, I did have an issue where someone had gone and on YouTube, now I'm not talking about Facebook, I'm talking about YouTube, where they had bid on something and then I couldn't contact them. I couldn't find them. And even if I can, one lady on YouTube, I looked to find her and it took me a while to find her when really YouTube people, you need to contact me. And because this has been going really well where you buy it on Friday, you pay me on, I send you a bill on Saturday, you pay me on Sunday, and it goes out Monday if I can get it out. You know, it goes out not later than Wednesday at the latest, but so far we've been able to get them all out on Monday and Tuesday. So if you are watching me on YouTube, make sure that you go to this at the very least and get a reminder, you know, and like I said, if you're watching this on Facebook, even in the replay, you could go and type stamp this below and I'll send you a reminder via Facebook Messenger. Okay, so you'd still have to have Messenger. So anyway, I'm so glad that you came. I thank you so much for the likes. Thank you so much for being my Stampin' Bud. You know, thank you for sharing. And you know what? I'm going to give more stuff away on Friday. So why don't you come back then? God bless. See ya.